But regardless.
No, he wasn't even on the platform. Because I grabbed him and narrowed him to the platform.
Oh,
the platform,
wow.
Like, came by. Yeah, that's why it was, like, really situational.
Yeah. Regardless, though, Seltzman to die off one mistake.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
And that's why everyone kind of had hype for Lucario as well. Because
yeah.
It's just, like... I mean, like, if you have a character... Okay, like, if you have DK, you're good. Because, like, you kill him early enough.
Yeah.
But if it's like Sheik, for example.
It's really hard to deal with Lucario's a freaking truck, man.
Honestly, I want to say Lucario wins that matchup.
Versus Sheik?
Yeah.
I remember way back in the day, like DS days, people were talking about how, like, when Sheik was, like, undefeatable,
mm-hmm.
Everyone was like, Lucario might be the answer. Lucario might be the answer. The problem with that matchup is by far the, it's by far the fact, but Lucario's frame data is kind of, not great.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard for him because, like, Sheik can just continuously hit him. The problem is that if Sheik makes one or two mistakes, or sorry, two or three mistakes, right, it's over.
Yeah.
Whereas Lucario has the, is able to make a lot more mistakes.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Misses that tech.
Yeah.
He didn't have a jump?
I guess not.
That's weird. He must have, like, just got up with, like, jump or something.
Maybe.
I've had that happen.
Death Horse right now.
Yeah. Death Horse actually doing so amazing right now. Today he's kind of been on fire. Like, he started kind of weak, and then, like, he's finishing just strong.
Death Horse is really, really an exceptional player from Canada. One of the best teams.
Yeah. I mean, Locust for sure, but, like, it's pretty close after that.
I feel like if Death Horse got out much more, he'd do so well.
Yeah.
It's hard, too. When you're a player like Death Horse who does so well at weeklies, it's hard to get out of that stance of, like, going to weeklies.
Yeah.
So I find that he doesn't do as well at majors, but I think the main reason why, it's definitely not because he's bad. It's more just because he gets nervous because, you know, you go all that way.
Yeah.
And it's like, if you lose...
It's that... Wow. Yeah, that was...
That was an absolute clinic.
Yeah, 78%.
Disgusting. Death Horse really showing why he's the best model right now.
Just grab the chip. I don't
sad
see the paper on it. Yeah, I know. They kind of got stuck to it. I don't know why. You thought.
So right now, Fred is taking the lead at the beginning, but CSS low percent combos are really good. Oh, these up airs! No. Okay, yeah, there's no way that was gonna kill him. Holy moly.
Just leave it out for now.
Oh, I mean, flip off.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Red won in this right now. He just wants those strings, my man. He's like, I feel like he's like, you know what? There's a good chance I'm gonna clunk this one. I'm not gonna do well.
So
I
let's
may
just
as well
it,
just commit
yeah.
as much as I can. Like, I may as well, like, commit to everything.
Jab to boost kick? Oh, on Mewtwo? I think that might be true.
I'm pretty sure it is. It's a lot like, I think it's a lot like how Mewtwo or Mac, Little Max, often will do, like, jab one up B. Up, it's kind of like a new Mac thing. And it's not confirmed, but it's a good mix up because,
yeah.
A lot of people get caught off guard.
Oh my goodness. Just barely gets that down B.
That was amazing. That movement into the down B as well was really, really good.
Mm-hmm. I forget how that move works. Is it like kind of like Sonic's homing attack where like it homes? I know you can do it earlier, but...
I think so. It's I feel
is
like
that?
It's,
oh my goodness.
Greg.
Wow.
2 for 2, my man.
Wow.
Absolutely. Incredible. I don't even have to say that. That was pretty gross. But we're gonna see another game right here, right now, you know? find like so many of Bread and Death Horse's matches are like destruction on one end and destruction on the other end.
For sure.
It's really cool. And Bread, I feel like he's playing quite different right now because a lot of times he'll play like kind of passive, like he'll just throw at Nair's Zara's stuff like that.
Yeah.
But that game, he was just going for every extension of every combo. He did, if true or not, he was going for it, right? And it really paid off for him because Death Horse didn't see it coming.
Yeah,
well,
yeah, I thought that was going to be a jab lock, but it's definitely way too high percent.
Yeah. Well, I think it's just because he didn't do the smallest shadow block. You have to do the very smallest one for the jab block, so I think he did a little bit bigger than that, but I'm not sure I was really paying attention. Oh, that's going to do it.
Yeah, wow. Oh my goodness, I can't believe that kills.
Yeah, how dare a character's up smash kill?
Is that 90?
I mean, Wario's up smash doesn't kill like that.
Oh my goodness, calls out that down B with the down tilt. That was actually so rude. Up air. And this is looking like the very first game.
Yeah, this is definitely
Dr. Wily's castle.
My god, Death Horse right now.
I mean, it's gonna be real hard for Bread to come back from this.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, that happens so much, I find. Like, you'll see it, Bread throw out an up B in neutral, and a lot of the time you won't get punished because you'll think he's going the other way. I think it's more just a mission of patience, right? Like, you have to kind of wait exactly for him to land to punish.
Yeah.
And you can't overextend your punish. You should go for something big. I think if Death Horse, maybe Death Horse meant to turn around and accidentally jab, but because I don't think he would have just jabbed to punish them.
No, no.
Unless he meant to, like, jab footstool down there. Oh my god. And as you saw last game, ZS has a slight bit of rage, but she could still make this one back.
Yeah. And honestly, at the very beginning, I thought this was already over, but you know what?
Oh my god.
Bread.
This is he might have connected
too
much.
Is that it? Oh wow, okay, staying alive.
Nice DI.
I think the reason he might have went for down smash is because he thought Bread was going to expect the forward smash and DI it wrong and die or something.
Yeah.
But even then, wouldn't forward smash kill at that percent?
I don't think so, honestly. I think the reason why he went for down smash maybe is the hitbox is bigger
and
he wanted
a
guaranteed punish.
Yeah. Now smash is going to kill.
But I might be wrong.
That makes sense. I know a lot of people do that when they're like up in the air, they use a recovery move and you're like, this should be so easy to punish, but you can drift, so I'm going to do something safe. Like, for example, I'll do down smash just in case they land on the opposite side.
Yeah.
So I'm like, just in case I'm covering both options.
Also, the forward smash is easy. Sends him forward. So
we're seeing the Lucina. The Lucina. Who's
Death
Bread
Horse
going?
Wants to end this tonight with the Lucina.
Bread's going zero suit, as usual. Let's,
no, don't keep going right now. Oh my god. Lucina's damage output is insane. Two hits and it's 22%.
I mean, like, it's because they don't really combo into each other, so
yeah,
they're like,
so they're
yeah, so they're just like, well, oh, that was a good up
yeah,
to get out of that combo. Is this it?
Not
maybe, okay, I feel like he's going Lucina, for one, to practice Lucina, because he does have Lucina, oh my goodness.
Yeah, Brett's just like, don't
he's like,
on me.
No secondaries here, boy.
Yeah, man. Well, Death Horse has a Bowser. He would do very well versus J-Pez's Bowser.
Like, Bowser is one of those characters where it's like, you get punished once, you freaking die at like 40.
Against Bowser?
Yeah.
I mean, J-Pez's pretty cool.
Yeah. But at the same time, when he's Diddy Kong, he dies at like 40. To Bowser's shenanigans
yeah.
with rage.
Bowser's scary to deal with as Diddy. You really have to banana.
Is that
that's
it?
It.
Oh
no.
Oh wow. Living.
You saw that video.
Yeah. That,
no,
my
way.
Goodness.
Yeah, it's probably a bit stale. It's probably a. Lylat as well has the tilting
yeah,
factor.
That's it.
Yeah.
What'd you say, sir?
Oh, I think he taunted. Anyways, what I was going to say was, Oh yeah, you saw the video of the guy on Lila, right? And he jumped near, or
yeah, yeah, with Sheik,
and he just
yeah.
fell in there. That was weird, man.
Gethor's going back to that, the classic Mewtwo.
Yeah.
Not gonna try a secondary, but thinks, you know what, probably a bad idea. You know, that works against me, I'm a scrub, I play Falcon. If you play any character against me, I'll lose. But, like, not quick.
Well, Falcon loses, like, every match as well.
Out of the top twos.
Kappa.
Probably. But they're not, like, unbeatable. That's what I like about Falcon.
He loses them,
but it's not like, you know, impossible.
The only Falcon matchup that's unwinnable is Falcon versus Wario. Just unwinnable for Falcon.
Brent getting some decent damage on right now.
Hey man, if I'm gonna be like most people on Twitter who's like, they definitely win that matchup because Gluttony beat Fatality, so Wario beats.
Yeah.
Like, okay. Anyways, so right now we're at game 5. Brad really playing a setup for that game, or for the run back.
Yeah. I mean, Deathverse might have made a mistake going Lucina. Like, obviously he's got another set if he does lose this, but like, that just gives Brad more time to download.
Oh, Brad is doing so well. I really think it took one win for Brett to kind of get back in it.
Yeah.
I think he was experimenting more the second game, but as soon as he came to that conclusion that, like, I can do this, it was a lot for him, because I know that Brett is a very determined player a lot of the times. He was the first person
to beat JPEDs.
All because he was determined to win, and it's in a matchup that's really, really hard for Zero Zone.
At the time, was he playing Luigi?
I think he was playing Diddy and Luigi.
Oh, yeah, I think it was.
But I'm pretty sure he went Diddy against Red.
Red having a hard time right now trying to find this kill. Oh, and that up smash is going to do it.
Just the tip.
149%.
Yeah,
jeez.
Red at 84. That's definitely kill percent for him, but he can definitely keep Death Rolls off. He's doing quite a good job. And
up smash, that's not going to kill yet.
Oh, thank gosh. That would have been messed up. But yeah, Death Horse, I don't know if Death Horse. Oh
wow,
my
that forward
god.
Are gonna take it. Get the balloon. Oh,
okay,
it's too far away now.
I don't want to sound biased, but I hope Death Horse wins because I want this to end so I can get a glass of water.
Yeah.
But,
true.
Also because Death Horse is like amazing. Like one of the most hyped players in all the world.
Down tilt, forward air. Yeah, Deathwars doing an amazing job coming back right now. Jeez.
Oh my
goodness, these call-outs right now.
Nice call, yeah.
Like, this is looking real rough.
Looking like a Gmo spec.
The double hit.
Oh my god.
I was like, my heart just like...
Deathwars like, you're not getting up there, zombie.
And
that's gonna do it. Really nice game.
That was a good set.
Not even...